when I'm going to be home for the majority of the day, I like to let the chickens out of their pen. Hey Blondie, why don't you come on out? Everybody else is out here. She's still in there. Mr. Roo likes to keep his ladies around him. He makes funny sounds as he tries to show them where to scratch up and get food. And when he thinks that they have had enough time, he gathers the hens and he gets them to all go back in the pen. So it's really kind of nice having a rooster. I like having a rooster. Plus, he's replenished our flock. I think I only have 5 of the original hens that we started with. All the rest of them are replacements, thanks to Mr. Roo. So he's very useful. Right now I have 12 out here and 4 in the house. Here's the babies. They're 17 days old. I keep them in the house until they're fully feathered out. See, right now they still have fuzz on the top of their heads and on their bellies. But their wings are starting to fill up with feathers, and they're starting to grow their tail feathers. But they'll stay in this box, in this tub. I'm gonna put the cover back on. They're getting big enough, so they might try to jump out. So that's my whole flock. I originally started with 17. But he's been a good rooster. He's not been mean. He's never attacked me. He is kind of protective of his lady, so I have to be careful that I don't do anything that he would think is threatening to them. And they're all one big happy family. Now that will change up when I bring the 4 babies out. But they'll be kept separate in the little pen until they're big enough that they can defend themselves. But at least there's 4 of them. So I've learned from experience that they'll kind of hang together as a group. The chickens are enjoying their day out. Mr. Rooster keeps watch over his ladies. It's almost as though he calls them to where he's at. Say, here's some good pickings. Here's a good place to find some bugs to eat. And they tend to follow him. Mm-hmm. hear all this rustling of leaves. I could probably find crickets and grub worms. Oops, you found something. You found something. Oops. Oh, that's why she stayed in the coop. Stayed in the coop because she's got an egg to lay. He hears her, so he's going to go check it out. He wants to make sure that she's not in distress, even though all she's doing is laying an egg. What a good little rooster he is. He's making the same sound she is. I think she just announced that she laid an egg. See, he cares about his ladies. What a good little rooster. I like him. Are you quite comfortable, Carlotta? So she came out after she laid her egg, and now she's digging in the pine straw and leaves. Oh, we got another one in there laying an egg. It's that time of day. That's funny how they have to announce. They have to announce when they've laid an egg. I thank you. That's a good girl. I need to open that other door. The younger ones especially follow him. Well, it's 10:30 in the morning. Are you in here already, Mr. Rooster? Well, it's been a short time outside. Let's see. Well, I won't be able to tell because I have two ladies sitting. Blondie. Oop, I almost fell over. So they're sitting on the nest, so I can't count the eggs yet, but they're doing their duty. You've only been outside for a little bit, Mr. Roo. I'm surprised you're back in already. So we got two ladies sitting, and Mr. Roo and all his young ladies are already back in the pen because they follow him. There's five of them there. So that means the older ladies are still out and about, wandering in the yard somewhere. somewhere. All I have to do is listen. See how they follow him? He's definitely the leader of the flock. He directs them where to go and where to find food. And all I have to do is listen for the sound to find where the other hens are. And here they are. She's found herself a nice little comfortable spot. These are the older ladies. They're a little more independent. They came before the rooster. So they're not so devoted to him as the younger ladies are. That's a little pen. When the babies in the house get big enough, they will be in that pen until they grow to be about the size of the adults, and then I'll let them join the rest of the flock. But it's really great having these different pens. So if I need to separate them, and I do have a door on each one so that I can let them out on days when I can keep an eye on them. I have had hawks steal some of my chickens or kill them. I did have a problem with a dog for a while and lost 3 chickens to the dog. I got rid of that dog. But the dog I have now, he doesn't bother them. He knows they're my babies. He's watched me raise them from babies. And he knows I take care of them. So he just kind of ignores him. Yeah, Rusty's been a good dog. He's been a good dog. He doesn't bother my chickens. We're just one big happy family around here, right? Everybody gets along. The cats don't bother the chickens. The dog doesn't bother chickens. Bless you, Rusty. Sometimes I see the baby hens, or the young hens, will clean off the rooster's face. They kind of groom him and keep him well groomed, and he just stands there and lets them do it. They just pick at his face. You almost think they worship him. The young ones grew up with him, so they have a different relationship with him than the older ladies do. The older ladies run from him because they're more independent, and sometimes he catches them. But the young ones seem to be very devoted to him, and they seem to have a trust relationship with him. Yeah. And he has his own sounds. He makes sounds that the ladies don't make, which is kind of cool. Now let's check on the egg. I see 3, 4. And there still might be more coming, so I'll just let them be for now. Hello, miss. Hello. Yeah, I come in here so he came and see. Okay, what's go, let me investigate. He's got to keep an eye on everything. I have this new waterer. It has little nipples on the bottom that they get their drink that way, because the other water heater rusted out. But I'm worried about this one during the winter because it might freeze. So I might have to go back to a metal one, because at least with a metal one I could put it on a heater. It took a while. About 3 days for them to figure out how to drink from this container, but they finally did figure it out. So, but I'll probably have to switch back to the metal container for the winter time. That way I can keep the water from freezing, because I'm thinking if the water freezes in this bucket, it would crack the bucket. So I'll probably only use this bucket during the summertime. Well, it looks like he's got the whole flock inside. And the door is still open. They could go out if they wanted to. I guess Mr. Roo called them all in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, they're all here. Well, that's pretty cool. That makes it easy for me. So I can just lock them up. I don't have to chase chickens. Good job, Mr. Roo. I guess you decided that the ladies need to come back in.